And welcome to Lake TV's Community Spotlight Show, where every week we get to talk with a community leader from some area in the local community, whether it's business or nonprofits or schools. And today we're checking in on the nonprofit world as we've got the executive director of Kids Harbor with us, Kara Gerdeman. Kara, thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me today, Chris.
Okay, so from like day one that I moved into the community, I heard about Kids Harbor and how great an organization this is. So what is Kids Harbor?
Well, Kids Harbor is a child, fully functioning child advocacy center. Our mission is to provide coordinated response, healing, and prevention of child abuse. We're both a place and a process. So as a place, we're a safe, child-friendly setting where kids can come and talk about abuse that they may have experienced, and also heal from any of that trauma that they've experienced. As a process, we bring together law enforcement, children's division, juvenile officers, medical and mental health providers, so that kids aren't having to go to the police department and then to children's division and then tell their story to a prosecutor and then have to go have a medical exam. We do all of that in one place at Kids Harbor. Kids are interviewed in our interview room, just the child, and a specially trained forensic interviewer. And while those team members that are investigating the case are watching the interview from a separate room.
It's one of those organizations that it's a necessity. Unfortunately, it's a necessity, right?
Absolutely.
So your job has to, I mean, you've got to hit the highs and the lows of everything in that job, having great days where you know you're just doing great things and helping people, and then probably days that just tear you apart.
We have a really great staff that works directly with kids every single day and listens to the stories of what has happened to them and what they've been through. And our staff, I mean, they do a phenomenal job. But there's a lot of self-care and taking care of one another within our staff as well, because those things are hard to hear. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, then we also get to see those kiddos that are going through the counseling process and healing, and we get to follow them through that process and see them graduate from counseling. And, you know, sometimes we even have special graduation parties for them when mm-hmm. they're graduating from the counseling program and after they've healed, we've had their safe caregivers there, and we may have cupcakes or something just to celebrate them and how far that they have come through that process.
How cool is that? So now you are the executive director, Kara Gerdeman here, and you grew up in Ozark, I think, not too
yes.
far away, right?
Absolutely.
In a pretty historic place too, I guess.
Yes. So the house I grew up in, my grandparents lived there before my parents lived there. It was kind of they had a hotel in that area. But back in, I think 1994-ish, somewhere around that time, Johnny Morris, owner of Bass Pro, bought my family's house, and my grandparents lived next door and all the property, and as well as the mill that we grew up next to running around, and my grandpa worked for years. So
wow.
We have that little bit of history of where I came from.
Did you have to check Johnny Morris's credit before you sold to him or what? Probably not. So you grew up in Ozark, so you're a Missouri girl. How did you make your way to Kids Harbor?
So I graduated in 1996 from Missouri Southern State College with a bachelor's in criminal justice administration. Mm-hmm. Went to work out of college at the Juvenile Justice Center here in Camdenton as a deputy juvenile officer, and I spent about 10 years working delinquency, child abuse, and neglect cases. And an opening came up at Kids Harbor. I'd seen Kids Harbor kind of come into existence in 2001. And I'd seen how cases were handled before there was a Kids Harbor, and then after, you know, Kids Harbor had been here, and how much better that was for kids. And so I applied, and I was hired as a child and family advocate at that time.
Yeah. And just kind of moved up the ranks, and yep. One day you're running the whole show over there as executive director.
Yes.
All right. So is it a job that is fulfilling?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I strongly believe in our mission. I'm a huge believer that kids deserve healthy, happy childhoods, mm-hmm. and anything we can do to make a world a safer place for them, it is one of my highest priorities, making sure that kids can heal from any of that trauma that they've experienced, and getting them in and helping them find their voice. I mean, these kids have been through so much, mm-hmm. and seeing them find their voice and open up and share, you know, what has happened, what an honor that is, that a child would feel comfortable with our staff in sharing that, and even going further and deeper through the counseling process and healing, and sitting with them as they go through court, and have to testify in court, mm-hmm. sometimes, and all of those things. You know, one of the things that I'm the most proud of with Kids Harbor in the last few years is we've really brought back our prevention program, and are doing a lot of prevention work. We have the Child and Teen Safety Matters programs that teach about child abuse and cyberbullying, bullying, as well as digital images through schools, and we are in a lot of schools in the area, providing that at a grade appropriate, developmentally appropriate level. Mm-hmm. So we love that, and we love that we also have the Stewards of Children program that we can provide that education to adults and help adults understand their responsibilities and to recognize and react responsibly to abuse. We know kids aren't responsible for their own safety. Mm-hmm. That's up to us as adults to protect them.
Mm, absolutely. So we're getting to know more about Kids Harbor. This is the Executive Director, Kara Gerdeman, and we will have more with Kara on the Community Spotlight Show right after this.
Your car wants to look its best. The paint, the trim, the wheels, the tires, they want to show off in all of their sparkling glory. Let your car shine with the Quick Car Monthly Unlimited Wash Club. For one low price, you can let your car strut its stuff anytime you want. Your car will thank you. Welcome to the club. Quick Car. Quick, easy, and professional every time. In Jefferson City and Osage Beach.
If you love the lake, you gotta love Lake TV.
Your time on the water is limited, and Hy-Vee and Osage Beach knows it. Let us do the shopping so you can maximize your lake time. With our Isles Online app, you can have your groceries delivered or ready for contactless pickup when you arrive to the lake. With all your grilling favorites, snacks, fresh produce, and home to the lake's largest wine, spirits, and beer department, your weekend at the lake starts with Hy-Vee and Osage Beach, where you'll find a helpful smile in every aisle.
And welcome back to Lake TV's Community Spotlight Show. We're getting to know more about Kids Harbor with Executive Director Kara Gerdeman today. And so Kara, you guys are celebrating a pretty big anniversary over there at Kids Harbor, right?
We are. 2021 is our 20th anniversary of existence. You know, we were established by a group of community members back in 2001 who were concerned about the way children were treated during a child sexual abuse investigation, and look how far we've come. I'm really proud of the work we do and the kids that we've served, and the number of lives that we've had positive impacts on.
Yeah. Do you hear from these kids for the rest of their lives, or is it something they want to forget and you never hear from them again? How does that work?
You know, you hear from a few here and there,
yeah.
That will get a phone call. I had a phone call not too long ago of a child that had charges filed in court, and it had been a number of years since their initial interview. And it was just a wonderful moment that they called and said, thank you. And I was so happy for them that they were finally getting that, starting to feel some of that justice, and that we could be there through that process. And there's kids through the years that you go on and you see, or they'll come back and visit, or we run into here and there. And
yeah,
it's always nice to see that and hear from those kiddos of how great they're doing. And we also know there's other kids that don't want to.
Right. They just want to forget.
Don't want to talk about it. They want to forget and move on. And that's okay too. We're just happy for them and happy we can provide those services. And we don't stop our services just because a child graduates. If if 3 or 4 years down the road something happens and they feel like they need to get back in for counseling or something, mm-hmm. all they have to do is give us a call, and we are happy to always provide those services.
They're always a part of the family.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's pretty cool there. So how are you guys funded? I mean, do you need contributions from the community? Do you need volunteers? How does that work?
Absolutely, we need both of those things. We are a nonprofit 501c3. Most of our funding comes from grants. We have a state contract. We do get some reimbursement for the medical exams that we do. But most of our funding comes from grants that are competitive in nature, that we reapply for every year or every couple of years. We do a lot of fundraising in the community as well. April is a big month for us. April's Child Abuse Prevention Month. Mm-hmm. So you'll begin seeing pinwheels. The blue pinwheel is the national symbol for child abuse prevention. And it signifies the happy, healthy childhood every child deserves. And it's just a reminder out in our community that we can put more emphasis on that child abuse prevention and how we can keep kids safe. We also have a first annual Wings and Swings virtual golf tournament coming up toward the end of March, and we'll have more information up on our website and our Facebook page on that, as well as our barbecue bash that'll take place probably first part of May. 2020 has been a rough year for everyone, and it's certainly had some struggles for us as well. You know, we were notified last July that one of the grants that we count on that funds our prevention program isn't going to be offered in 2021, not because of anything that we have done, but simply because the agency has just chosen to go a different direction this year, mm-hmm. which that prevention program is such an integral part of our organization and what we do. We've had kids that through that prevention program, Child and Teen Safety Matters at School, have gotten that education and then gone to their counselor and disclosed that something's been happening to them. And then they get referred to us for, you know, that forensic interview and the medical exam, and we can provide those services as well as counseling to make sure that they get on the road to healing and get the justice that they need.
Okay, so if people want to volunteer, or they want to give, or they just want to find out more, how do they go about doing that?
They can go to our website. Our website's kidsharbormo.org, and there is all kinds of information on there about Kids Harbor, what we do, who we are. There's different ways you can get involved, including our volunteer applications and how to contact our volunteer coordinators to have an interview and see if you would be a right fit for our organization, mm-hmm. as well as our fundraising activities, any of that kind of information. And you can also check out our Facebook page. Our Facebook page is under Kids Harbor Inc. as well, and follow us along there, and we provide updates on all the things that are going on. We also keep our wish list of things that we need currently on both of those pages.
All right. So, and how big is your staff? How many volunteers do you need? What's the numbers look like?
So our staff is, we have 21 staff members at this point in time between our two offices. We have the office in Osage Beach, mm-hmm. as well as an office in St. Robert, Missouri. And last year, we had 731 children referred for services. In 2019, that number was 913. Our volunteers, we use for a variety of different things. One of our biggest grants requires a match, cash match, mm-hmm. and we can make that match through volunteer hours. So our volunteers do everything from helping out with our parent education courses, providing childcare or meals during that, or sometimes even teaching that course, as well as doing data entry. We have volunteers that help with our landscaping.
Takes everything, really.
Yeah. Everything. Right. Absolutely.
Okay, we just have a few seconds left. Again, if folks want some more information or they want to contact you to volunteer, how do they go about that?
They can get a hold of me at my email address is cgerdeman@kharborcac.org. Or they can give us a call at the office, and all of that information is on our website, kidsharbormo.org, or on our Facebook page.
Okay. Well, there you go. Kara Gerdeman, the Executive Director of Kids Harbor, thank you so much for coming over. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much for having me.
All right. And be sure to watch the Lake TV Community Spotlight Show at 8, 3, and 8 weekdays on Lake TV.